Bodhidharma. Bodhidharma was a Buddhist monk who lived during the 5th or 6th century. He is traditionally credited as the transmitter of Chan Buddhism to China, and regarded as its first Chinese patriarch. According to Chinese legend, he also began the physical training of the monks of Shaolin Monastery that led to the creation of Shaolin Kungfu. In Japan, he is known as Daruma. Little contemporary biographical information on Bodhidharma is extant, and subsequent accounts became layered with legend and unreliable details. According to the principal Chinese sources, Bodhidharma came from the western regions, which refers to Central Asia but may also include the Indian subcontinent, and was either a Persian Central Asian or a South Indian, the third son of a great Indian king. Throughout Buddhist art, Bodhidharma is depicted as an ill-tempered, profusely bearded, wide-eyed non-Chinese person. He is referred as the blue-eyed barbarian in Chan texts. Aside from the Chinese accounts, several popular traditions also exist regarding Bodhidharma's origins. The accounts also differ on the date of his arrival, with one early account claiming that he arrived during the Liu Song dynasty, 420-479, and later accounts stating his arrival to the Liang dynasty, 502-557. Bodhidharma was primarily active in the territory of the Northern Wei, 386-634. Modern scholarship dates him to about the early 5th century. Bodhidharma's teachings and practice centered on meditation and the Lankavatara Sutra. The anthology of the Patriarchal Hall, 952, identifies Bodhidharma as the 28th patriarch of Buddhism in an uninterrupted line that extends all the way back to the Gautama Buddha himself. There are two known extant accounts written by contemporaries of Bodhidharma. According to these sources, Bodhidharma came from the western regions, and was either a Persian Central Asian or a South Indian, the third son of a great Indian king. Later sources draw on these two sources, adding additional details, including a change to being descendant from a Brahmin king, which accords with the reign of the Pallavas, who claimed to belong to a Brahmin lineage. The Western Regions was a historical name specified in the Chinese chronicles between the 3rd century BC to the 8th century AD that referred to the regions west of Yumeng Pass, most often Central Asia or sometimes more specifically the easternmost portion of it, for example Altishar or the Tarim Basin in southern Xinjiang. Sometimes it was used more generally to refer to other regions to the west of China as well, such as the Indian subcontinent, as in the novel Journey to the West. The earliest text mentioning Bodhidharma is the record of the Buddhist monasteries of Luoyang, Luoyang Kuailanji, which was compiled in 547 by Yang Xuanzi, a writer and translator of Mahayana sutras into Chinese. Yang gave the following account. The second account was written by Tanlin, 506-574. Tanlin's brief biography of the Dharma master is found in his preface to the long scroll of the treatise on the two entrances and four practices, a text traditionally attributed to Bodhidharma and the first text to identify him as South Indian. Tanlin's account was the first to mention that Bodhidharma attracted disciples, specifically mentioning Deng and Dazhu Haik, the latter of whom would later figure very prominently in the Bodhidharma literature. Although Tanlin has traditionally been considered a disciple of Bodhidharma, it is more likely that he was a student of Haik. Tanlin's preface has also been preserved in Jingju's, 683-750, Langjia Shiziji Chronicle of the Lankavatara Masters, which dates from 713-716. Ca. 715 he writes, in the 7th century historical work Further Biographies of Eminent Monks, Shu Jaising Xuan, Daoxuan, 596-667, possibly drew on Tanlin's preface as a basic source, but made several significant additions. Firstly, Daoxuan adds more detail concerning Bodhidharma's origins, writing that he was of South Indian Brahmin stock, Nantian Supayua Menshong. Secondly, more detail is provided concerning Bodhidharma's journeys. Tanlin's original is imprecise about Bodhidharma's travels, saying only that he crossed distant mountains and seas before arriving in Wei. Daoxuan's account, however, implies a specific itinerary. He first arrived at Nanyue during the Sung period. From there he turned north and came to the kingdom of Wei. This implies that Bodhidharma had traveled to China by sea and that he had crossed over Xiangtze. Thirdly, Daoxuan suggests a date for Bodhidharma's arrival in China. He writes that Bodhidharma makes landfall in the time of the Song, thus making his arrival no later than the time of the Song's fall to the southern Qi in 479. Finally, Daoxuan provides information concerning Bodhidharma's death. Bodhidharma, he writes, died at the banks of the Luo River, where he was interred by his disciple Dazhu Haik, possibly in a cave. According to Daoxuan's chronology, Bodhidharma's death must have occurred prior to 534, the date of the Northern Wei's fall, because Dazhu Haik subsequently leaves Luoyang for Yi. Furthermore, citing the shore of the Luo River as the place of death might possibly suggest that Bodhidharma died in the mass executions at Heian, in 528. Supporting this possibility is a report in the Chinese Buddhist canon stating that a Buddhist monk was among the victims at Heian. In the anthology of the Patriarchal Hall, Zhu Tengji, of 952, the elements of the traditional Bodhidharma story are in place. Bodhidharma is said to have been a disciple of Prajnatara, thus establishing the latter as the 27th patriarch in India. After a three-year journey, Bodhidharma reached China in 527, during the Liang, as opposed to the Song and Daoxuan's text. The anthology of the Patriarchal Hall includes Bodhidharma's encounter with Emperor Wu of Liang, which was first recorded around 758 in the appendix to a text by Shen Wei, a disciple of Huineng. Finally, as opposed to Daoxuan's figure of over 180 years, the anthology of the Patriarchal Hall states that Bodhidharma died at the age of 150. He was then buried on Mount Shangar, Shangarshan, to the west of Luoyang. However, 3 years after the burial, in the Pamir Mountains, Song Yun, an official of one of the later Wei kingdoms, encountered Bodhidharma, who claimed to be returning to India and was carrying a single sandal. Bodhidharma predicted the death of Song Yun's ruler, a prediction which was borne out upon the latter's return. Bodhidharma's tomb was then opened, and only a single sandal was found inside. According to the anthology of the Patriarchal Hall, Bodhidharma left the Liang court in 527 and relocated to Mount Song near Luoyang in the Shaolin Monastery, where he faced a wall for 9 years, not speaking for the entire time. His date of death can have been no earlier than 536. Moreover, his encounter with the Wei official indicates a date of death no later than 554, 3 years before the fall of the Western Wei. Subsequent to the anthology of the Patriarchal Hall, the only dated addition to the biography of Bodhidharma is in the Jingde records of the transmission of the lamp, Jingde Chuan Denglu, published 1004 CE, by Dewan, in which it is stated that Bodhidharma's original name had been Bodhidharma but was changed by his master Prajnatara. The same account is given by the Japanese master Kaizen's 13th century work of the same title. Several contemporary popular traditions also exist regarding Bodhidharma's origins. An Indian tradition regards Bodhidharma to be the third son of a Pallava king from Kanchipuram. This is consistent with the Southeast Asian traditions which also describe Bodhidharma as a former South Indian Tamil prince who had awakened his kundalini and renounced royal life to become a monk. The Tibetan version similarly characterizes him as a dark-skinned siddha from South India. Conversely, the Japanese tradition generally regards Bodhidharma as Persian. Several stories about Bodhidharma have become popular legends, which are still being used in the Chan, Xian and Zen tradition. The anthology of the Patriarchal Hall says that in 527, Bodhidharma visited Emperor Wu of Liang, Xiaoyan, posthumous name Bodhi, a fervent patron of Buddhism. This encounter was included as the first koan of the Blue Cliff Record. Failing to make a favorable impression in South China, Bodhidharma is said to have traveled to the Shaolin Monastery. After either being refused entry or being ejected after a short time, he lived in a nearby cave, where he faced a wall for 9 years, not speaking for the entire time. The biographical tradition is littered with apocryphal tales about Bodhidharma's life and circumstances. In one version of the story, he is said to have fallen asleep 7 years into his 9 years of wall gazing. Becoming angry with himself, he cut off his eyelids to prevent it from happening again. According to the legend, as his eyelids hit the floor, the first tea plant sprang up, and thereafter tea would provide a stimulant to help keep students of Chan awake during Zazen. The most popular account relates that Bodhidharma was admitted into the Shaolin Temple after 9 years in the cave and taught there for some time. However, other versions report that he passed away, seated upright, or that he disappeared, leaving behind the Yijin Jing, or that his legs atrophied after 9 years of sitting, which is why Daruma dolls have no legs. In one legend, Bodhidharma refused to resume teaching until his would-be student, Dazhu Haik, who had kept vigil for weeks in the deep snow outside of the monastery, cut off his own left arm to demonstrate sincerity. Jingde records of the transmission of the lamp, Jingde Chuan Denglu, of Daoan, presented to the emperor in 1004, records that Bodhidharma wished to return to India and called together his disciples. Bodhidharma passed on the symbolic robe and bull of Dharma succession to Dazuhaik and, some texts claim, a copy of the Lankavatara Sutra. Bodhidharma then either returned to India or died. Some Chinese myths and legends describe Bodhidharma as being disturbed by the poor physical shape of the Shaolin monks, after which he instructed them in techniques to maintain their physical condition as well as teaching meditation. He is said to have taught a series of external exercises called the 18 Arhat Hands and an internal practice called the Sinew Metamorphosis Classic. In addition, after his departure from the temple, two manuscripts by Bodhidharma were said to be discovered inside the temple, the Yijinjing and the Shuijing. Copies and translations of the Yijinjing survive to the modern day. The Shuijing has been lost. According to Southeast Asian folklore, Bodhidharma traveled from Jambudvipa by sea to Palembang, Indonesia. Passing through Sumatra, Java, Bali, and Malaysia, he eventually entered China through Nanyue. In his travels through the region, Bodhidharma is said to have transmitted his knowledge of the Mahayana doctrine and the martial arts. Malay legend holds that he introduced forms to seal it. The Hayana tradition links Bodhidharma with the 11th century South Indian monk Dongpa Sangyi, who traveled extensively to Tibet and China spreading tantric teachings. 3 years after Bodhidharma's death, Ambassador Songyun of Northern Wei is said to have seen him walking while holding a shoe at the Pamir Heights. Songyun asked Bodhidharma where he was going, to which Bodhidharma replied, "I am going home." When asked why he was holding his shoe, Bodhidharma answered, "You will know when you reach Shaolin Monastery. Don't mention that you saw me or you will meet with disaster." After arriving at the palace, Songyun told the emperor that he met Bodhidharma on the way. The emperor said Bodhidharma was already dead and buried and had Songyun arrested for lying. At Shaolin Monastery, the monks informed them that Bodhidharma was dead and had been buried in a hill behind the temple. The grave was exhumed and was found to contain a single shoe. The monks then said, "Master has gone back home and prostrated 3 times, for 9 years had remained and nobody knew him. Carrying a shoe in hand, he went home quietly, without ceremony." Bodhidharma is traditionally seen as introducing dhyana practice in China. One of the fundamental chant texts attributed to Bodhidharma is a 4-line stanza whose first 2 verses echo the Lankavatara Sutra's disdain for words and whose second 2 verses stress the importance of the insight into reality achieved through self-realization. The stanza, in fact, is not Bodhidharma's, but rather dates to the year 1108. Tanlin, in the preface to 2 Entrances and 4 Acts, and Daokxuan, in the further biographies of eminent monks, mention a practice of Bodhidharma's termed wall-gazing, Bigwan. Both Tanlin and Daokxuan associate this wall-gazing with quieting the mind. In the 2 Entrances and 4 Acts, traditionally attributed to Bodhidharma, the term wall-gazing is given as follows. Daokxuan states, "The merits of Mahayana wall-gazing are the highest. These are the first mentions in the historical record of what may be a type of meditation being ascribed to Bodhidharma." Exactly what sort of practice Bodhidharma's wall-gazing was remains uncertain. Nearly all accounts have treated it either as an undefined variety of meditation, as Daokxuan and Dumalin, or as a variety of seated meditation akin to the Zazen, that later became a defining characteristic of Chan. The latter interpretation is particularly common among those working from a Chan standpoint. There have also, however, been interpretations of wall-gazing as a non-meditative phenomenon. There are early texts which explicitly associate Bodhidharma with the Lankavatara Sutra. Daokxuan, for example, in a late recension of his biography of Bodhidharma's successor Haik, has the sutra as a basic and important element of the teachings passed down by Bodhidharma. Another early text, the Record of the Masters and Disciples of the Lankavatara Sutra, of Jingju, 683-750, also mentions Bodhidharma in relatianto this text. Jingju's account also makes explicit mention of sitting meditation or zazen in other early texts. The school that would later become known as Chan Buddhism is sometimes referred to as the Lankavatara school, Lankizan. The Lankavatara Sutra, one of the Mahayana sutras, is a highly difficult and obscure text whose basic thrust is to emphasize the inner enlightenment that does away with all duality and is raised above all distinctions. It is among the first and most important texts for East Asian Yogacara. One of the recurrent emphases in the Lankavatara Sutra is a lack of reliance on words to effectively express reality. In contrast to the ineffectiveness of words, the sutra instead stresses the importance of the self-realization that is attained by noble wisdom and occurs when one has an insight into reality as it is. The truth is the state of self-realization and is beyond categories of discrimination. The sutra goes on to outline the ultimate effects of an experience of self-realization. The idea of a patriarchal lineage in Chan dates back to the epitaph for Faru, 638-689, a disciple of the fifth patriarch Hongren, 601-674. In the long scroll of the treatise on the two entrances and four practices and the continued biographies of eminent monks, Daiwan Dazu Haikarith the only explicitly identified disciples of Bodhidharma. The epitaph gives a line of descent identifying Bodhidharma as the first patriarch. In the 6th century, biographies of famous monks were collected. From this genre, the typical Chan lineage was developed. D. T. Suzuki contends that Chan's growth in popularity during the 7th and 8th centuries attracted criticism that it had no authorized records of its direct transmission from the founder of Buddhism, and that Chan historians made Bodhidharma the 28th patriarch of Buddhism in response to such attacks. The earliest lineages describe the lineage from Bodhidharma into the 5th to 7th generation of patriarchs. Various records of different authors are known, which give a variation of transmission lines. Eventually, these descriptions of the lineage evolved into a continuous lineage from Shakyamuni Buddha to Bodhidharma. The idea of a line of descent from Shakyamuni Buddha is the basis for the distinctive lineage tradition of Chan Buddhism. According to the Song of Enlightenment, Zhengdao Ji, by Yang Jiazhuan Jue, 665-713, one of the chief disciples of Huineng, was Bodhidharma, the 28th patriarch of Buddhism in a line of descent from Gotama Buddha via his disciple Makasyapa. Poem Mahakasyapa was the first, leading the line of transmission. 28 fathers followed him in the west. The lamp was then brought over the sea to this country, and Bodhidharma became the first father here. His mantle, as we all know, passed over 6 fathers, and by then many minds came to see the light. Poem The transmission of the light gives 28 patriarchs in this transmission. Bodhidharma has been the subject of critical scientific research, which has shed new light on the traditional stories about Bodhidharma. According to John McCrae, Bodhidharma has been the subject of a hagiographic process which served the needs of Chan Buddhism. According to him, it is not possible to write an accurate biography of Bodhidharma. McCrae's standpoint accords with Yanagita's standpoint. Yanagita ascribes great historical value to the witness of the disciple Tanlin, but at the same time acknowledges the presence of many puzzles in the biography of Bodhidharma. Given the present state of the sources, he considers it impossible to compile a reliable account of Bodhidharma's life. Several scholars have suggested that the composed image of Bodhidharma depended on the combination of supposed historical information on various historical figures over several centuries. Bodhidharma as a historical person may even never have actually existed. Dumoulin comments on the three principal sources. The Persian heritage is doubtful. According to Dumoulin, in the description of the Lo Yang Temple, Bodhidharma is called a Persian. Given the ambiguity of geographical references in writings of this period, such a statement should not be taken too seriously. Dumoulin considers Tanlin's account of Bodhidharma being the third son of a great Brahmin king to be a later addition, and finds the exact meaning of South Indian Brahmin stock unclear. And when Taosun speaks of origins from South Indian Brahmin stock, it is not clear whether he is referring to Rootsy nobility or to India in general as the land of the Brahmins. These Chinese sources lend themselves to make inferences about Bodhidharma's origins. The third son of a Brahmin king has been speculated to mean the third son of a Pallavian king. Based on a specific pronunciation of the Chinese characters as Kangji, meaning fragrance extreme, Tsutomukam identifies to be Kanchipuram, an old capital town in the state Tamil Nadu, India. According to Tsutomukam, Kanchi means a radiant jewel or a luxury belt with jewels, and Puram means a town or a state in the sense of earlier times. Thus, it is understood that the kingdom corresponds to the old capital Kanchipuram. Acharya Raghu, in his work Bodhidharma Retold, used a combination of multiple factors to identify Bodhidharma from the state of Andhra Pradesh in South India, specifically to the geography around Mount Salem or modern-day Srisalam. The Pakistani scholar Ahmad Hassan Dani speculated that according to popular accounts in Pakistan's northwest, Bodhidharma may be from the region around the Peshawar Valley, or possibly around modern Afghanistan's eastern border with Pakistan. In the context of the Indian caste system, the mention of Brahmin king acquires a nuance. Broughton notes that king implies that Bodhidharma was of a member of the royal caste, and kayas the caste of warriors and rulers. Brahma is, in Western contexts, easily understood as Brahmana or Brahman, which means priest. According to tradition, Bodhidharma was given this name by his teacher known variously as Panyatara, Prajnatara, or Prajnadara. His name prior to monkhood is said to be Jayavarman. Bodhidharma is associated with several other names, and is also known by the name Bodhidharma. Foray notes that Tibetan sources give his name as Bodhidharmatara or Dharmatara, that is, highest teaching, Dharma, of enlightenment. Buswell dates Bodhidharma abode in China approximately at the early 5th century. Broughton dates Bodhidharma's presence in Luoyang to between 516 and 526, when the temple referred to, Yongningsi, was at the height of its glory. Starting in 526, Yongningsi suffered damage from a series of events, ultimately leading to its destruction in 534. Traditionally, Bodhidharma is credited as founder of the martial arts at the Shaolin Temple. However, martial arts historians have shown this legend stems from a 17th century Qigong manual known as the Yi Jin Jing. The preface of this work says that Bodhidharma left behind the Yi Jin Jing, from which the monks obtained the fighting skills which made them gain some fame. The authenticity of the Yi Jin Jing has been discredited by some historians including Tang Hao, Xu Zhen, and Matsuda Ryuchi. According to Lin Puan, this manuscript is full of errors, absurdities and fantastic claims. It cannot be taken as a legitimate source. The oldest available copy was published in 1827. The composition of the text itself has been dated to 1624. Even then, the association of Bodhidharma with martial arts only became widespread as a result of the 1904 to 1907 serialization of the novel The Travels of Lao Tzu in Illustrated Fiction magazine. According to Henning, the story is clearly a 20th century invention, which is confirmed by writings going back at least 250 years earlier, which mention both Bodhidharma and martial arts but make no connection between the two. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.